Yeah, we've been waiting for a bit on this.
We're actually going to we're going to ramp up the proceedings, aren't we? We're all going to have a bit of a go.
We are. Yes, it's going to be pretty intense. Mm. So this is called Wild Horse. Hope you enjoy it.
Coin to decide who was going first. And
clearly I lost.
And then now I've got to follow that, you see. So
swings and roundabouts, as they say.
This is a song called Gasoline and Matches. And I wrote this song before I knew of the band Gasoline and Matches. And,
but it could be their theme song.
It could be their theme song. If they needed a theme song, I'm here for it. I'll sort them later when they get here. But I wrote it about... It's about that spark of a beginning of a relationship when one of you is a lot more into it than the other person and you feel like you're kind of chasing after something that's never going to happen. And it goes a little bit like this.
Gasoline Maybe, I don't think Gasoline and Matches are here yet, so maybe like if we drink all afternoon, then when they come on later we can demand that they play that song.
Yes, that's a good idea.
They won't know anything about that, but
we'll
it'll be like everyone in the crowd will be in on the joke.
You just commission them to play, but you can't start singing your songs.
Yeah, sing Gasoline and Matches! Yeah. We can just do that, like, over and over again.
I think it's a great idea, I'm on board with that.
Yeah. Okay, hi everyone. We are the Jackson Line, and minus gin. But never mind, you know, I think we'll be fine with that. So this first song we're going to play is kind of a good example of how we end up writing tunes or kind of lyrics, which is taking a few different things that are happening and they end up smashed together in a kind of melting pot of ideas. And this one, I was kind of helping a friend who was going through some loss, let's give it that broad term, and at the same time, me and my wife were watching a Netflix Western called Godless. Anyone seen that?
Yeah.
Oh, good. And that's all about kind of, I'll try not to spoil it in case anyone wants to watch it, but California in that show is really kind of, you know, the place everyone's trying to get to in that Western era. So I had this kind of, you know, supporting my friend and at the same time watching this show where California was like really the place where everything was going to be okay. And that's how this came about. So this is California.
I should be grateful this feeling strange, 'cause it's like a red hot burning pain. Things I should have said, but I just never found the time. Maybe I'll go to California, where the ocean California. You can't live your life full of regret. Won't be no help on the road ahead. But sometimes you gotta draw a line in the sand. 'Cause what is gone for good. Maybe I'll go
was
Like this is actually you kind of get pushed on to do that extra little bit every time because you're following some amazing music every single time you get to sing again. So that was stunning. I'm
sorry
sure,
to do that.
No, I'm sure she's up there and absolutely loved that. Just like
so that song wasn't written about her, but yeah.
If it's okay with you, I'm going to attempt to follow that.
Just don't cry, there's not enough tissues to go around.
Or just cry immediately.
I don't really cry. That's kind of
what
I'm
sharing is caring.
I'm going to play you a brand new song that I've only actually sang in public once before. I was over in Clapham with Lucy Bloom a couple of weeks ago and I debuted it there to a small yet perfectly formed audience. And I'd like to share it with you guys, if that's okay.
Heck yeah!
It's a song called I Rolled the Window Down, which is a really odd title for a song, I get it. If you kind of just go with me a little bit, it's the first time I've ever written a song from about somebody else, and it's not a personal perspective, so it's kind of special to me, so please let me know if you like it or don't like it, whichever, but just let me know. We'll wait for Tara to fall off.
See your face.
that last room? It's too dark.
It's a little bit dark, isn't it, at the end? It's kind of my take on a murder ballad, except it's not. I'm not murdering anyone, so.
Yet. Nice. That was great. Also, I think in a writer's round, you can, like, we're not here to kind of sing, if that makes sense. Like, the singing is not as important as the writing, but goodness me, your voices are fabulous.
Thank you. So.
Okay, so at the last, we host a writer's round in Chelmsford, in Essex. Anyone been there? Yes, three people. It's the cultural capital of the east of England. It doesn't have that title, but let's pretend it doesn't. So we host a writers round there, and the last one we did, we had Gasoline and Matches and Two Ways Home, and I challenged them. I like to kind of ask questions as we're doing it, and I ask them what they're kind of, you know, if someone said, we need this song, we're going to go to Gasoline and Matches, what would it be? And they said drinking songs. Two Ways Home, I think, fluffed it. I can't remember what they said.
And then, they hadn't rehearsed.
No, exactly. Yeah. So anyway, then Jim, because I was like, well, I don't actually know what ours is, and then Jim was like, divorce, obviously. And
I think it was the one word he said all night. Actually.
Yeah. In fairness. Yeah. Jim in our band, he doesn't say much. He's a man of extremely few words, but yeah, everyone heard him just go, divorce. So anyway, I thought we'd sing a song about a divorce for you. But I just want to kind of give you a little bit of a backstory here, because it is an emotional song, but you know, we don't want to cry or anything on stage, because...
No, because I've done enough of that.
Exactly, really, only one. They did say only one person could cry during each round.
There's a quota.
Yeah, exactly, tier quota. Friends of mine were going through a divorce, and we were kind of seeing it from both sides. We were friends with both of them, me and my wife. And anyway, so I happened to say to my wife, it was the husband leaving the wife, and I said, you know what, I think it's kind of brave to kind of make that decision and move on and, you know, try and live your life in a different way. Now, I'm not sure if you ever thought about having that conversation with your wife where you say that the guy leaving his wife is brave for doing that.
Yeah, how did that go for you?
It didn't go well at all. But a few days later when we were talking again, it gave me like the beginnings of a song, and you know, it, like, her perspective was very much, it's not brave, Keith. And anyway, so that led to this very emotional song. But I'm glad I have a humorous story to introduce an emotional song. This is great.
Great stay when your heart's already gone. tried to save this love a long time ago. Don't tell me that it's afraid to say, I'm sorry, but I'm leaving you today. Do we tell the kids and who gets the house? Now here you are, standing in front of me. We'll bear him each hand, and you can see anything to help me understand. Don't tell me that it's brave to say, I'm sorry, but I'm leaving, cause I'll tell you that it's brave to stay. What's wrong if you were brave and tried to save this love instead of saying goodbye? Don't tell me that it's brave to say, I'm sorry but I'm leaving. Sorry but I'm leaving. Sorry but I'm leaving you today.
Sometimes you just can't push it down, get it to be a bit south when you're singing. Anyway, this next one is much more lighthearted, and I don't think I'm going to cry on this one, so you'd be pleased to know. And this was co-written by Kelly Williams, who I failed to mention co-wrote Wild Horse with me as well. That we write together quite a bit. And this was kind of lyrically Kelly's baby. She just said, you know, I wanted to write like the cheesiest, corniest, like, song with a metaphor of like fishing and love kind of going on. And she played it for me. I'm like, I love it. I absolutely love it. So we kind of wrote the rest of it together. And this is going to be my next single. It should be out either late June or early July. I have to get it organized. But yeah. Tara Hinton Music. I'm on all socials as that. So please connect. And my single will be coming out soon for this. So I hope that you guys enjoy. It's called Fishing for Your Love.
Chance to lean in and steal a little kiss.
gonna take to pull you in? Are you hooked on me like I'm hooked on you? I'm waiting around like a lovesick fool. I'll stay right here as long as I need to.
Embracing the cheese though, isn't it? I love that. You're gonna do cheese and just rub
just
it.
Go
grab it with two hands.
And then go fishing.
Well, you all seem to enjoy that, and when Cal played a song that everyone had to sing along with earlier, you all enjoyed that. So I've got a little bit of audience participation in this song. How are you feeling for it?
Oh yeah.
Are you up for it? Yeah.
Do we need ribbons?
Ribbons? Not today.
Not today, sorry.
Sorry to let you down. it's actually a song I'm currently in the process of recording, ready to release this summer. And a few people in the room here have donated their vocal talents to it already.
You know who you are.
Yeah. And then in the chorus, well, actually, first of all, before we start, I want to just put a kind of disclaimer out there. I wrote this before the current energy crisis, so when I start singing about leaving lights on, I'm not being flippant.
Well, you could flip the switch.
But the chorus goes, will you leave the light on? Oh, oh, oh! Oh, oh, oh. That's all you've got to do. It's not rocket science, people. If you can't join in by the second chorus, you're not country. I'm sorry.
Oh, there's a bar is mine here, folks.
I went there. But this is a song about being 40-something and still out there traveling up and down the country playing, sometimes, not today, to empty bars and missing home. This is a song called Leave the Light On. Another night, another town, same sky, different clouds above. Singing to these empty bars, saving space in my empty arms for you. The clock is ticking my life away. It's time the road ain't the same. Sleeping shifts while someone drives, counting cars to pass the time away. All those hours on the telephone, talk about how I'm coming home to you. The world is not this black or white, racing back to you. Thank you. with the amazing Jackson Wang.
Thank you, awesome. Okay, we're going to finish with a song that was kind of a me and Jamie collaboration. So this was, I hate to mention the pandemic, I'm so sorry, but I'm going to. Because I had the idea for this song because me and my son were away from my wife when good old Boris announced the very first lockdown. So we were in Suffolk and my family live in Essex. And the A12 runs between those two. And in my head, I was like, how am I going to get home tomorrow? Because we, you know, I had to get home, but the lockdown was announced for like that night. So I had all this kind of panic, imagining tanks on the A12. Because, you know, those WhatsApp stuff was going around at that point with all the, you know, bollocks. So I had this kind of real panic. Anyway, it was fine. Best journey I've ever had. But Jamie, that kind of summer, we played the Tennessee Fields Virtual Festival. And then on that day, Jamie was like, I've got an idea for something. And that was just kind of, you know, chord structure, a bit of a do-do-do. And then those things kind of came together to create a song where I was kind of imagining doing anything to get back to someone. Also, if you have enjoyed us today, you can find us on wherever you would normally go. MySpace, Friends Reunited.
And
AOL. Yeah. If my AOL handle is. And we're playing at Buckle and Boots on the Saturday, if anyone is going to be there. So please come and see us. We're on the Paddock stage, and that's at 4 band. So please come and join us. And then at Tennessee Fields Festival, we're going to play on the Friday night, hosting a songwriters round with some special guests as well. So if you want to catch us at some point over the next few months, that's how to do it. This song is called Gonna Get to You.
Couldn't help but smile, 'cause there's only one person that it could be. But I could tell by her tone there was something wrong. She said, you gotta get on the road if you got any chance at all to get to me. I guess it's gonna be a long night. I'll be there before the sun. Car back around, and I'm in a state bound cloud of dust in the rear view. I don't care if it takes all night, I'm gonna get to you. Well, we both knew it was gonna be hard when you first moved out of town. An opportunity just too good to turn down. And now that your comfort zone is where you grow, so we both knew you had to go. And we promised that we'd make it work somehow. But right now I guess it's gonna be a long night. I'll be here before the sunrise. Got the radio on, they're playing a song, and I'm back, and that's all with you. I don't care if it takes all night, I'm gonna get to you. Sleeping under the stars, wrapped up in your arms, we had everything we needed. Top down in the breeze, kicking back on the beach. Man, I felt so free. Perfect life in a picture frame. But the world was about to change. I guess it's gonna be a long night. I'll be there before the sunrise. Got the radio on, they're playing our song. And I'm back. All night, I'm gonna get to you. All night, I'm gonna get to you. All night, I'm gonna get to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody.